It's August 6, 2016. It is 9:50 a.m. The torch sunflowers are growing up pretty high. We've only had probably, I would say, all total now, 50 large-winged butterflies instead of, like, you know, 500. Look at the state of the sunflowers. See, the major thing I gotta say is the okra is way too close. I put them down way too close. They need to be at least 42 inches apart, and I've got some that are only like 28 inches apart, 30 inches. They're just too close. One of them down there is dying, I believe. I don't know, he's still coming out right down there. But see a sunflower here. Look at this. No bees. Well, a couple bees may have got on here. The butterflies and such. I mean, they're not being pollinated. You know, look at that. Look at so many flower heads on there. They're not pollinated. Look at this. It's a sad state right now. This is, and it is, it's not me guessing, it's not me saying maybe. This is because of the chemtrails, Fukushima fallout, and, you know, people laugh about that because they are stupid, because they're clueless. I was a praying mantis on that one. Oh, that's his shell. So he already, whatever you call it, molted, whatever he does. That's the shell of a praying mantis. It's not a praying mantis. He got off of there already. But every once in a while I see a couple small little bees on here. Look at this. This is the average sunflower out here now. Look at that. Some of the birds got at some of it, which is good. Now, at least they're getting some seed from it. I was going to use all the seeds for next year's ewe around the garden. The tomatoes are disgusting. I mean, here's one of my Titan sunflowers. Again, see, they're not being fertilized. They're not being pollinated, rather. And watch this fertilizing. See, look how you can almost see the seed behind it, but, you know, hey. And look at them all the way down the garden like that. I'm going to zoom in and just stand here. And you see all them brown leaves, which is them dying off and such. Look just beyond, about 25 feet, not even 25 feet. Oh, yeah, that's Monsanto cotton, of which they spray the most toxic fucking shit all over it for the bugs. And they spray it weekly. Yeah, but that has nothing to do with these, right? Right, my ass. That's why I'm blaming that. Fukushima, the radiation, which is probably radiation out here. You don't, you know, I mean, like I say, all the people that giggle about this stuff, you're just the stupidest. You're as stupid as a pile of dog shit. Okay? Fukushima's gone around the globe 7 times, around that or more. Different, it's covered everything with radiation, yes. Look it up, idiots. You'll get some that'll even say that Fukushima never even happened. You know, give me a fucking sledgehammer. But anyway, you got Fukushima going around here. The chemtrail spraying, which again, if you look up there and you see, like, it looks like a powder and all that, those aren't clouds. I mean, again, people are living in denial. Look at, this will be life on the planet here in about another 5 years. If it gets that far. People are all worried about this election bullshit right now. It's rigged. Yeah, it's rigged. They're telling you, you know, the Illuminati, if you ever heard of them, look them up. The Illuminati, they tell you what they're going to do right in your face because they know you're too stupid to figure it out or you do anything about it. Here's a tomato plant. Not one tomato, not one bloom on it. This one here got some type of a disease already on it. Well, not already, but been on it. No blooms. That one there, I had about 8 tomatoes I got off, of which 3 of them were just bad. They were bad. They had bad spots on them. This one here, I had about 4 tomatoes off of them. 2 of them were okay. The other 2 were so-so. On 1 to 10, this one here had probably 3 of them that were a 2. And then maybe the rest of them were about a 7. They weren't really great tomatoes. This one here, 1 tomato. No blooms. No blooms. 1 tomato. And look, it's still with us. It's still right there. Sweat's dripping off my elbow. Where is it right now? This one I planted from in the house. When I put it out here, let me zoom it all the way out so you can... I can't see it. It was about that tall. Okay, it was about, I'd say about 14, 16 inches. Now it's about 3.5 feet. It does have 4 or 5 blooms on the flowers. But look at the leaves on there. And they all get fertilizer. They're getting a little bit of lime underneath. And, you know, this is just the outcome. And again, I am blaming it with full confidence. Fukushima, chemtrails, and just the stupidity of people, I guess, is all I can say. Look at this one. Not a single bloom on it. This one here, I think I have one tomato off of here, which wasn't really great. The little plant that I've kept out here, it was brown, and I fed it and everything. And look, it's coming back. Now that it's the first week of August, yeah, that ain't gonna make it. But I kept giving it fertilizer once every 3 to 4 weeks, watering it, and it came back. See, it didn't die. I mean, the stuff should grow out here. But look at some of these beans now. I'm gonna show you these beans, and then I'm gonna go show you the sunflowers in the back. That's a Mexican bean that we planted. I thought I planted too. I'm quite sure I did. I might have actually tore up one because it was just dried out. There's another one. But see, it's late in the year, and I think beans got to be planted like the last of January, and let them grow February. The last of February. I'm growing March, April, and into May. That's when you get your beans mainly. But look at these others: the black-eyed peas and purple hull peas, which are a big one from. Down here in the south, a lot of people don't even know about them, but they know about them now, I should say. There are a lot of people that realize, well, look how they're growing pretty good, pretty strong. I generally put down 2 beans in each hull, so I have like 2 black-eyed peas and 2 purple hull peas down there, and then right over there is 2 black-eyed peas. Oops, out of focus. So these are growing okay, but at the same token now, again, you see how these leaves are right here, so, you know, look at the leaves on this one right here. I'm gonna zoom in on it as tight as I can. I'm trying to look on the viewfinder. It's got a bright reflection, so it's hard to really see good. Yeah, see the spots all over it? That's a disease, I'm pretty sure. I'm not a botanist or anything. But see how it is on this one only? That's just driving me crazy. I mean, again, I ask for comments, I get stupidity, and I get nothing. So, like I said, I've always said it, I'm trying. What the hell are you doing? Okay, in the back here, this is the northern wall, I guess you'd say. You got one sunflower that looks somewhat healthy, if you want to call it healthy. But no, that's not even the wall. The wall's back here. Next year, I'm expanding all the way back to where that tall grass is, so you know, it'll be closer to their toxic stuff. It's going to be a little bit wider, too. I'm going to try to make it about 8 deep. I mean, it's going to be thick. You know, this is thick, too, but... And unfortunately, I'm sorry, it's at their expense. They're dying off because of this toxic shit right here. You know, all this stuff that you put on your body. Which, yeah, it's okay. You know, it's cheap. It's cheap. I can afford it now. Yeah, wait a couple, 6-8 months, maybe. 6-8 months, yeah. Start reading about the 1920 or 1929 depression. That's gonna look like a cakewalk compared to what's coming. But you know, that's just me saying that. Okay, don't have to laugh at. I mean, look at, listen to what I'm saying. You know, ignorance knows no bound. Yeah, but look at the sunflowers. I mean, look at all of them, all the dead ones out here. All the way down like this. See, this is a couple. I've got different mixed sunflowers in here too, so you can just tell by looking at the flower itself. You know, that one there, compare that sunflower right there compared to the one back over this way again, compared to one out there. I'm not gonna go. There's a bee actually on it. See, like I said, we'll get a bee or two on there, but that's the thing, a bee or two with all these sunflowers around here. We should have almost 2 swarms of bees out here. You know, but, you know, that's okay. Don't worry about it, you know. We want some cheap shit. We want some Monsanto poison. I mean, food. Look at that. Those aren't going to have any seeds that you can use. I wouldn't use them. Yeah, flowers. See, there are blooms on okra too. That honeybees go into that. Right here's an okra. Like here, it's got the flower on it open. See inside there. And that's what helps produce the okra. Last year we had 5 gallon buckets of okra almost twice a day. By this time, we were doing 5 gallon buckets in the morning and 5 gallon buckets in the evening. Now we're lucky if you get in a gallon ice cream container, about a third of it. That's it for the day. So yeah, but nothing's changed. Don't worry about it. Hillary,
Trump,
Hillary, Trump. See, this is my massive mammoth sunflower. I was expecting to get a bunch of seeds out of this one. This one has been pollinated more, but still, I would say only about 30% of it's been pollinated. There's another one on the other side of the garden. Now these sugar baby watermelons, again, we had three. We took one off. There were four on here, three on here. We took one off, and we had these three. That one there, and now we got one here. It's about the size of a 12-inch softball. All right, the first week of August. So by mid-September, that one should be ready. Because the heat's been a little bit uncharacteristic, yeah. It has nothing to do with Fukushima. See, again, Fukushima happened March 11, 2011. And I don't say these things just because I'm blowing it out my ass, you idiots. I'm trying to inform you so you can try. What a joke. So you can try to help yourselves, if not your families at least. Fukushima happened on March 11, 2011. And that was part of HARP. You know, HARP was it? I mean, again, I've been doing this for about 18 to 25 years, roughly, depending on how you look at it. Looking it up. Now, the sun in the morning, when we moved here 4.5 years ago, the sun rose right about there. And then it would come to right just on the edge over there, and it would come straight up over us. So wait, let me zoom in and try to get my finger in there and focus at the same time. It was right there, and it would slowly come over here by, you know, like around June, it would be right here, and it would come straight up, almost directly over, and set west. Now, the sun comes up now in August. Now this is by June. It was coming up right there. Wait, let me zoom in. By June, it was coming up just on the other side of the trees, perfectly aligned with this house. Now it's coming up over here. Now, that's not me making it up. That's just a fact. When March 11th, 2011 happened, Fukushima, HARP had thrown an ionosphere. See, they're trying to control the weather. These idiots, these fucking insane idiots, are trying to control the weather. Control the weather, you control the food, you control the food, you control the people. Duh. Oh, they wouldn't do that. Yeah, give me a fucking sledgehammer. I swear to God, I'm so sick of the stupidity of this nation. In fact, the planet. Other countries are laughing at us because the stupidity in this country. The stupidity of what's going on right now. Oh, Hillary. Well, she's a woman. She's got experience. Sledgehammer. Oh, Trump, he's a businessman. Sledgehammer. You know, Trump seems to be the best guy. You know, this time it'll be different. You know, they've been saying this time for like the last 240 years. Hello? This time it'll be different though, right? Okay. Yeah, you keep holding on to that. I'll hold on to my common sense and what I'm trying to do. They have screwed up so bad. I read about 7 years ago with the chemtrails, which I've been swearing and cussing about all that while you people just fucking put your head up your own asses and smell the coffee, basically, evidently. But anyway, the chemtrailing has been so bad. I show you the trees, the bark on the trees. See, trees take water from the ground, and they're older and older. A lot of these trees are probably about, around minimum 65 years old, okay? Look at that stuff on the bark. It's on all the trees now, even the pecan tree over there. Look at that one over there by the drive. Look at that gray on the bark there. That's telling you how much it's in the soil. I mean, trees don't change like in a year or two. You know, that's how much has been soaked into the soil. But you know what? Stick your head up your ass, go about your business, and vote for Hillary because she's a fucking woman, or Trump because he's a businessman. This time, it'll be different. This time. You fucking stupid morons. We got 300 acres of Monsanto chemicals around us. We're going to probably have cancer in the next years or two if we go that far. I keep saying that, and then I keep trying to catch myself. You know, if it goes past 4 years, I'd really be surprised. 5 years. But you know what? That's just me. Some loon who's trying to do something. You know, you can just sit with your thumb up your ass or stick your head up your ass for the smell, maybe better. And my beans, I keep putting them out here. They get healthy. Look how healthy this is. Now, this is the 6th of August. Insects, I can control them. I use natural baking soda and water for the disease types if it's getting spot. And I was doing that. But look at that one. Look at that one there. Okay, I mean, I've had several start here. You see these holes here on the plastic. You know, they're not just holes for decoration. They're holes where I started peas or beans. But again, starting late in the year, I'm given that. I was using that as a reason. I'm probably wrong because of all the shit that's being rained into them. Look at this one here. This one, for sure, I thought was going to come up. Yeah. But see, then you get these leaves. Now, let me show you this leaf from the tree. This falls on the plastic. And it's got bugs and it's got disease on it. So if your trees are diseased, i.e. from the chemtrails, i.e. from Fukushima, i.e. from the fucking pesticides around us, and it goes into the ground and it gets into the roots of your plants, nothing happens, right? Your healthy plants will come up, no problem, no worry. Go to the store, buy your fucking food, get the canned food. That's the best stuff for you. Make sure it's got lots of salt and sodium in it too, okay, for preserving it. Yeah, okay. Stupid. I want as many of you stupid people to fucking start dying off. So the rest of us can try to work out a way. When people say, well, there's nothing you can do about it. I need a sledgehammer. It's going upside that fucking person's head. I mean, there are solutions. It may not be the best, and it's not going to be easy. But you know what? The next person said, well, there's nothing you can do about it. You ought to just knock them so fucking hard upside the head that they don't even remember where to stick their head next time they want to put up their ass. Okay? There you go. Just trying to show you what's going on out here in the garden. Because of Fukushima, the pesticides, the radiation from Fukushima, the chemtrail. And again, there's two beans. Now, these were planted about maybe 3 weeks ago. And let me see if I can give you a scale with my hand. I got small hands too. Okay, it's about 5 inches tall, two of them. This one here was planted about 2 weeks earlier. That's about 7 or 8 inches tall. And I don't know if I put two down. I've been putting two down because I don't want to take no chances. Yep, two. Every seed I ever had from Heirloom Solutions, I put down one and one grow. See, right there is a perfect example. That's a cucumber right there. One seed was put down, one's growing. But chemicals from the shit around us, the Monsanto shit, by the way. Monsanto was the highest toxic poisons in the world. The ones who made Agent Orange, napalm, DDT, and a host of other toxic poisons wants to be the food supplier of the world. Can you add 1 + 1 = 10? Yeah, there it is. Well, there you go. So that's what the shit they put on the chemicals on the plants around. Well, they're not even food, or when it is supposed to be corn, it's a corn-like product. It's not corn. My corn right there got animals in it, and then it started getting all this stuff too. So look at the corn up on the hill over there. It's Monsanto corn I didn't know about until after these start coming up. I planted. He may be letting that go to feed because it's looking like it's drying out all around. So, you know what? I have no advice for any of you except for go fuck yourself if you don't do anything. Because, you know, they want you dead. The insane actually think they're going to... Well, they're going to merge with machines, folks. Yeah, and you think that's funny. Like I said, everything I've said, you can look it all up. You'll find stupid stuff with it. Oh, they're not going to... Well, that's the whole idea, to keep the stupid people even stupid. So they laugh at the people who are trying to make anything different to make it better. Disgusting. Like that right there. Look at all my sunflowers out here. I'm bringing them out again next year. I've got some other seeds from last year's harvest. I hope that'll work better if I don't get anything. as many as I want. But anyway, hesitant to even use them. I'm going to go out there. I'm going to take a string and a stick down there, come out to here and make it as strong, straight as possible. 20 feet back in the plastic, up to that back grass out there, and 20 feet out the other side. All I can tell you is, you know, been trying to tell you to plant yourself some tomatoes, pepper. Tomatoes are not easy to grow either right away. They say they're easy. They're easy to get started. Once you get them outside, they're really difficult to take care of. Unless it's just because of all the toxic shit. I got 3 bees over here now. Or 2 bees. Yeah, where were you guys at about a month or 2 months ago? Dying off somewhere, maybe. Because, you know, bees, they hurt you. They're hurtful. You know, those are the things that help the whole food chain, you idiots. When the honeybee goes, I think we got like 3 years after that. 5 years if you're going to try to make yourself survive on Monsanto's phony, bullshit, chemically induced food. Fucking stupid people.